Hi there, guys. I'm Chris Bowden.
I'm Javi.
Welcome to the Geek Group. We're here to do an autopsy. This isn't our theme of the past few have been like, you know, very heavy in aviation stuff.
Yeah, this is an aviation gizmo.
Because we're cleaning out robotics, mm-hmm. and I've got all this old avionics stuff, and it's mm-hmm. just cool. Mm-hmm. And I want to do a flight recorder, you know, the black box, which are actually neon orange. Okay. But I can't, because somebody else did one of those, and they did a really good job of it, and I'm like, that's cool.
No point.
It's all right, because I don't have one anyway.
Okay.
But I got this, and there's like science.
I've been looking at it. Do you have any idea what it is?
I think it's a gyro IMU kind of dingus. I think that this
because it has hand drawn X, Y, and Z.
I think this is a really expensive version of something that costs 20 cents and is in here.
Yeah.
But it's cool.
But it's cool because it has aerospace written on it.
Yeah.
So
and anything aerospace is
four extra zeros.
So let's grab the tools. And the first thing I want to do is take it off this base.
Okay.
Wait. Before you break out the tools.
Oh, it's like someone made it to do that. You gotta do it.
I'll do it where they can see the thing.
Yeah.
Ah. That is a serious lock-in widget thing. I don't know what this is called. It's like a cam screw Lotus locky thing, but it's cool. All right, now watch your fingers. No, lay it back. Tilt it up. There you go. There.
Oh, everything just fell to bits.
Look at that. They're like...
It's all cammed in.
Dovetail cam in lock pins with a wedge on this side and these here and pins that.
Most sincerely should not be...
That would have taken me a month's work just to make the thing it bolts to. That's sexy. And the whole thing, just two screws and you're out. And this part bolts to the plane.
Toolless construction.
That is sexy. And these are inserts?
Mm-hmm. So you can swap out.
Oh my God. This is the kind of stuff that, this is why I like aerospace. It's like, let's build a thing. We don't care what it costs. Yep. Let's just build a thing.
Build a list of 50 things that could go wrong with this screw and let's put 50 different alterations on it.
Yeah. All right, so now we've got lots of parts here. So I'm going to take this big chunky cable right off, which is just... See, this is the nice thing about doing the aerospace
autopsy stuff. See, I noticed there is a lot of labeling on all of this, but there's also these big Sharpie markers to indicate axis. Everything has been marked with X, Y, Z.
This is so sexy. Just look... Let's make a plug and spend $100 on it, just for one plug. You know, let's...
You reckon that's only $100?
Yeah. It wouldn't surprise me at all if I was holding a $500
What you can buy it for and what they charged for it, different
numbers. Yeah,
yeah.
So we're going to save a lot of parts off this, like mm-hmm. the sockets, the funny plugs and all that jazz. So,
okay.
Yeah. All right, which one do you want to start with?
Let's start with that one, because I don't know if that tape is...
That's just to keep it fresh.
This is, what would you like?
We need a razor knife to start. Let's start peeling away the layers of love. Here, you cut the tape.
Okay.
I'm going to... While you do that, I'm going to find the right screwdriver to do the other bit.
What do you need?
Huh?
What do you need?
For a screwdriver?
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm looking. Well, I got all the tools on this side.
No, I got all the tools on this side.
No, you got nothing.
No. Okay.
You got nothing. Oh, hey, that comes right out. Wow.
Where we find out this is actually a top secret.
I'm so used to doing autopsies where I just have to beat my way into things. And it's you get into the aerospace. I didn't even have to put a real screwdriver on.
Yeah.
I just put it in there. I was like, is that the right side? And I just boop, and it pops right free. I was like, oh, this is so nice. This is so nice.
We'll peel all this off, find out it's a mind control device, and this is helping us.
MK Ultra. It's okay. I've got protection.
Yeah.
Got my tinfoil hat for safety.
Just never ends. There's more of it.
It's all right. I'm going for a matching bikini.
Oh.
I'll put it on instead of my paints.
I don't think I'm getting anywhere. I think it's just a metal box underneath.
I think you're right.
So,
but it gave you something to do while I got all these screws.
You keep doing that.
Keep peeling. Keep peeling.
That's a whole lot faster. What are you doing to your
head? I just want to be pretty. Don't judge me.
Keep going. A long way to go.
This is actually faster than if I use the...
Well, I mean, I've got this one.
Are there screws up there?
Yeah.
Take them out. I'm just taking off everything that looks like a housing screw.
Because that's always worked so well.
Well, I don't have any better plan to get into the box. There's no screws on the bottom. There's a ring of screws around. Oh, there's still more over here. Okay. This was your side.
Well,
this was totally your side.
You had me cutting foil.
Okay, I think that's it. All right. Oh! Ow, 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 ow.
You ripped all your hair out.
It's all right. It's not a big loss. Haven't been worried about that one in a while.
You've got this.
I don't know if you're aware of this, but this ain't the kind of show where I'm really concerned with how pretty I am. If at the end of the show I still have eyebrows, it's a win, okay? Where are you going to stick that? Oh. Oh.
Wherever
oh, hey, hey, hey.
That's sort of that. A motto I've got.
Find out where that goes. It's probably an external temperature sensor. Ooh, man, look at that. Oh, wow. Yeah.
That hasn't been open in a while.
That hasn't been opened in a long time. But this, we got a little heater element here. Something in here moves. You can tell just by the shape of it. Something in here.
They've left a lot of slack on those cables.
Oh, God, it's so beautiful. I don't want to take it apart. Just
do
just
it.
Look at that. Oh, my God. It's so nice. A couple bodge wires up here. This is not something they made a lot of.
Okay.
Or this is something that cost a lot of money. You got a pair of pliers?
Yes. Oh, hang on.
What you got?
I don't know.
That's really on there. This is where the secret uranium fuel pellet goes. It's a little three-pin plug.
I don't know what this is, but there's a heap of cabling in there.
Look at this. I got a little three-pin plug.
Did you say
plug.
you found a heating element in there?
Yeah, it's a heating element right there.
Okay. I wonder if there's more buried up under there then.
Not with that many wires. You just need two for a heating element.
Depends if they're doing sides.
I don't know.
I'm going to keep going.
Oh, got a sticker here. What's the sticker say?
I don't know. Something about death if you touch it.
I've got some really sexy chips in here.
Oh, God.
What?
There's something about before removing or touching.
Make sure to see your radiation safety compliance officer at the NRC.
Yeah. No, it's ESD stuff. There's one on the back of the box as well.
All right, so I've got...
So it looks like...
Plus one AY, plus one AX, minus SA. This is... I'm going to take all this stuff off. Start taking off all the tape.
What?
All the tape.
Here?
Huh? Yeah, all the little bits of tape. Because they're going to catch us up in a bit. You know what I got to do before we do the next autopsy?
What do you need?
I got to find out who keeps stealing all my screwdrivers.
What do you need?
Well, this is what I need. What I need is to... Oh, that's...
I made the call. See, I was prepared. I didn't just fly into the set, tell them to turn the cameras on, and just walk in.
They set up.
Came here early.
They
made sure everything was set.
They say, okay, you want a job? Okay. Because I just, they tell me you shoot an autopsy.
Yeah.
I walk in the room.
Just turn up.
I sit
just hope
down,
it's all prepped.
And they say, do that thing you do. And I do that thing I do. And I try not to screw it up. And I try to, you know, be kind of smart. And God, look at this. This looks like something Kidwell made. on the camera. In all this, I mean, just look at that.
It's wonderful. It's a one-off.
This is totally handmade. This really looks like something Kidwell made for a prototype. Paul, you're missing your calling. You could be doing this and making a hell of a lot more money in the air now.
Look at the wiring back here.
It's all point-to-point wire wrap. That's art. All right, take that, and that off with pliers, and I'll start taking these off back here. This is the kind of thing where you could just take this, just this bit, leave this sitting on a park bench somewhere, and, like, bomb squad show up.
You know, you really shouldn't suggest this
sort
of thing.
I'm just saying.
Because they put me on a plane really quick. It probably doesn't go home.
No, but you get to see Cuba, which is lovely this time of year. Does that whole thing come... Yeah, it does. Start working your way into there. You could take the screwdriver. I was about to.
What are you going
to
do? Fight me for it?
Yeah, I'll do that.
I'll fight you.
I'm the good guy. Yeah. I'm like morally guaranteed to win. This is America. The good guys always win. Oh, you took the screwdriver.
Yep.
That's all right, because I can fish this way down in there.
You get that one in there.
And get that one out. Had one screw left. There's a few over here, but I can't reach those through the thing. Hey, I wonder if this unplugs. Yes, it does, but you got to take out the screws that hold it in, because these are aviation grade, so all the little plugs have screws on them over here. You're not going to be able to take that plate off until I take these screws out, just so you know.
I don't know what that is, but it's just come off.
That's the plug thing I was talking about. That was in the earlier part of the video.
Oh.
You might have. You should have tuned in earlier.
No. As soon as I hear your voice come over, I shut down.
That's a lot of people do. It explains a lot about my love life. Okay. Oh, look at this. I've never even seen that before.
It's not even...
Conformal goop.
No, the identification is just written on with a white pen.
It's not a date. 130.75, 134.08, and...
It's same sort of... What's the backside look like?
It's a
proper circuit.
Yeah. All right, so I got those off. So you can take this whole panel off, and we can open that right up now. And when that panel goes, then the bottom panel goes, and then the whole thing just is wide open.
Well, I'm just going to start back here.
I think... Yes. Oh, totally yes. All of my... Come here. Get out of there. If I spin this that way... Oh, yeah! Oh! I got it. Look at that. Look at that board. That is so hot. Oh, man. It's not... It's coated in, like, a waterproof coating. It's got, like, a thin layer of goop on it. But you look at this, and there's a lot going on here, but it's really clean and really simple. Like, whoever designed this was a guy who knows what he's doing. It was probably a team of guys. But, yeah, that's beautiful. I wonder what we could learn from this. See, this is where I wish I had somebody like Dave from EEV Blog, because he can read the chips and be like, oh, well, that's that, and that's that, and that's that, and I don't know this stuff.
And know what it does?
Yeah.
I got this. Too many screws.
But at this point, we're just getting down to the chewy inner goodness. Just want to get all the artistic bits off the outside. Someday we're going to open up the bottom of this thing and there's going to be a 50-pound ball of screws.
Yep. Hey, maybe that's what's killing the hydraulic.
Well, it's possible.
No.
These have the conformal coating on them, so you got to break them loose. Is there something on top of that?
I don't know.
Yeah, those just hold down heat sinks, so we don't care about those. Okay.
So I gotta ask, because you've watched some of the autopsy videos before.
One or two.
Being here on the set, mm-hmm. how is it different from your perception
at home? It's definitely built for midgets. It's most certainly built for midgets. It's not at all suitable for a person of normal size.
Whoa! Hey. What's that? All right, here. I'm gonna read this off. We can get some information here. I'm gonna actually turn that so you guys can see it clearly. Look at that. These are from SI. 53711. Okay. SOCN. Yep. 6687171. 6687170. 6687171. So this is a 101, and this is D6CL. This says digital control. DGCL. So those are, yeah, DGCL, digital control. And this is 9908, 9907, 9908. So these two are the same. This one's different. It's a digital control of some kind. It is the absolute most badass looking IC I have ever seen in my life. That's just a big chip. Just, God, that's beautiful. That's just art.
Are we cutting wires?
You can cut wires. I'm saving those. Oh my God. All right, what do you got? Teach him stuff.
Twiddly knob.
Well, that's just a plug. There's like a 3-pin plug in there. We talked about that in an earlier part of the video.
I'll have to go back and look.
Okay, you should rewind and check that out.
Everything is just written on with a pen.
Well, this is obviously a gyro somewhere.
Okay.
I don't know what kind. Let's take the little frame off. So now we're down into
the purple chamber of gold.
Didn't need all those.
Nope.
All right.
Bears.
Hey.
Hey.
Did you see that?
What? It's magnetic? No, it's just sticky.
It might be magnetic, or it might be the goop that's all over it.
Yeah, I think it's just the goop.
All right. We need an Allen wrench in that size, if you would please, sir.
What have you done to these tools? I wonder if that's metric.
It's metric.
You know how I said some of these kits don't have all the sizes in them?
It's got all the sizes. You can.
All the sizes.
We're not missing any tools out of it.
No, you're not missing all the tools, but that doesn't have the right sizes.
Maybe it's a secret military size or something like that. Oh, this one fits.
What is it?
This one's fits.
Second?
I don't know. It doesn't say what
it is.
It's
a torque bit.
It's yeah, but if you lean on it a little bit, it fits in the hole.
Oh, don't use it.
Got it. Hey, we tried everything we had.
You know what the difference is between being at home and being here?
What?
I can stab you.
I figure you don't get diplomatic immunity. If you got a better way, I'm all ears. Cause I got nothing. Thank you.
Hey, look.
What?
That one's loose.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Cool. Got it right out there, just like that. All right. Now I think.
Now you might have some goop on those wires that's going to hold it in.
No, I'm getting held in down here.
No, we're held in by those
don't pull that out. They slide out through the goop.
Oh.
So
maybe you want some
grab the wires and slide them out. Yeah, see, they come right out. And then you leave the goop behind.
Oh.
Conformal goop. Right, let's see if she comes out now. All right, goop over here. She can contend with. All right, I think that's all the heating bits. Oh, God, it's beautiful. Does that base come out of there?
I would have to imagine it's very heavily glued in there.
Do I have to take it apart any further? Can I just put it in its little stand and set it on a desk and call it art?
Turn it into a widget.
God, it's so pretty. It's a gyro
that
of
is
some...
most sincerely in there.
That's forever?
Mm-hmm.
That's two different pieces of metal.
I can lean on it with a hammer.
That's two different pieces of metal. I know it in my heart. That's
yeah,
two
it
different
is,
pieces
but
of
it
metal.
Is very sincerely in there.
It's made out of... It's made out of metal, and if it went in, it'll come out. That's all one piece.
One piece of metal.
Ah! Well, it'll fit in a vise, and we can make it two
yep.
pieces of metal. Yeah, we got
science
there.
We can make it one very big one.
All right, do you have a wrench that fits these? Because we got to think about what our next...
I brought it with me.
Huh?
I brought it with me.
Can you find an Allen wrench?
Probably not.
Okay, try. You gotta try. I believe in you.
See?
Yeah, I totally do.
That's so helpful.
Ah, so much goop. I don't know what this goop is, but it's substantial. This is definitely aviation-grade goop.
Aviation goop.
Aviation goop. You know it'll take it right off, though. I need you to run out to B&B Aviation and get me a 5-gallon bucket of prop wash.
No worries. I'll get right onto it.
Takes it right off.
Yeah, prop wash.
Okay.
Is that beside the left-handed screwdriver?
Kind of, yeah.
Yeah, and the striped paint.
Yep. I have.
Next time you walk into a locksmith shop,
yeah,
ask the apprentice to fetch a brass magnet. We've dropped a key down a door. We need the brass magnet.
Never heard it in a lock shop, but
yep,
that's a machine shop joke. But around the airport, it was bucket of prop wash. Mm-hmm. You know what you use prop wash for? Don't shake it. God no. All right.
Any idea what they are?
Yeah, it's a gyroscope. Dispel dynamically tuned.
Mm-hmm. And meanwhile, we've been throwing them around.
So yeah, this is a model 705683, part number 167444-0401, serial number, manufacturer number, and then a really big number. But it's made by Smith's Industries Aerospace in Grand Rapids.
What axis have you got on yours?
Oh, Y.
You got X and Y?
X and Y.
I got X and Y.
Okay.
They just changed one to a Z.
Another one Z.
Yeah.
You know, we have to open this.
Okay.
We just have to open this. Because we're never going to use it as a gyroscope. Why ever would you? It's huge. But...
I've got an accelerometer on the other side.
Yeah. Gyro and accelerometers in three pairs. Mm-hmm. So, gyro...
Two pairs.
No, that would be four. So, two gyros... I got three accelerometers. All right. Different size?
Yep.
Okay.
What?
I have the distinct impression that to open this may require the use of a lathe.
Okay, so the gyros are in there. Oh.
Is the end of that wrench in the hole?
Yeah.
I will live without the end of the wrench, but I want the screw out of the hole.
The gyros are metric. The gyros are imperial, and these ones are metric.
Okay.
Just just for something different.
Well, the gyros are Imperial because they're made by Smith's Industries in Grand Rapids, Michigan.
Oh.
Where's that razor knife? I have to cut the label off this, so I hope we got a good clear shot.
I'm going to take the other one off.
Ooh, you know those really nice, expensive aluminum foil labels?
Mm-hmm.
This is one of those.
It's one of those?
Yeah. But I think, I hope, all for nothing. I was hoping there was a screw under the label. No. This is going to be frightfully difficult to get inside of.
Told you, checks, yeah.
Yeah, there's bits inside. Oh, how do we open you without a lathe? Because I don't want to have to chuck this and start shaving off the outer container.
Do you care about this one?
Huh? We can butcher him the first one to get inside, because we have a couple. But now we've gone from autopsy into damn near lockpicking.
What do you got? One some more. Just pull one. Wait. Thank you.
What are you doing?
Trying to find out how to get in.
Well, it's not like a lock. You don't get in by pulling the pins out. Yeah, I got a similar thing here, this little tiny edge.
But
it's either going to be this edge here, which is the weak spot, or this edge here.
Expensive parts.
Yeah,
and
somebody...
most sincerely not coming apart.
They're coming apart.
Oh.
I don't know how. This is a Q-Flex accelerometer QA3000, part number 979-3100-003, date code 9823, so 23rd week in 98.
Okay.
Cage code 0YFPO, allied signal. What secrets does this behold?
Turns out there's just a little hamster in there.
If we have to put this in a lathe and very, very gently cut through the case and slide it out, we will.
Why do we need to put in the lathe through it?
It's the way easiest way. You just put it in a three jaw and shh.
All right.
That's what I got.
All right.
So we'll set these aside.
Cool.
Do we have more in here?
There are. There's a should be two more accelerometers and one more gyro.
Yep. All right. I'm setting this over
and
here.
And then we got this whole other thing.
We have a whole other box. We
got a whole other thing.
Which I gotta think is the brain for this.
Okay. That's all your problem. So there were some nifty labels on it. Delicate instrument, handle with extreme care. Yep.
All right, so find the thing that fits it.
Thing.
This is thrilling video. Seeing if they're all like that. Yeah, those are really in there.
Which one's the little Phillips on the side?
Those.
Oh, yeah, there's some at the top there as well.
Oh, hey. Try same those. Pattern on the top.
Try those.
I'm going to try it with a bigger screwdriver.
Yeah, they're really in there. Feels like Loctite.
This is like the perfect application for this thing.
Yep.
You gotta want it.
No, you gotta charge it.
Yeah, that one's forever.
And milled out the inside of the plate.
Yeah. Pocketed out. That's nice. Give me the other end. You want to try and get that one screw out in the bottom over there?
Probably.
I got just the hammer you need.
You got a hammer?
I got the best hammer ever. Just cuts keys.
So I've just learnt two things.
What?
Number one, that's probably the first time you've seen that happen.
No, no, okay. No, I've seen it. And, well, I actually have a tool and, just for that. I have this screwdriver.
Really cheap screwdrivers.
Wow!
I think I just blew the shaft through the bottom of it.
It's definitely shorter than when you started. This is a
so
quality
is this.
Pittsburgh. Oh, come on, isn't that great?
Yeah.
That's my little Craftsman Evolve screwdriver, or hammer. It's same. I don't know why
lucky
you're
judging
me.
Lucky I bought 10 of those. Oh. You know, at this point, you can just turn a screwdriver.
Huh?
At this point, you can just turn your screwdriver.
It's not that it isn't charged, it's that it doesn't have the stones, because these are held in with, like, goop. If that one broke off.
Yeah, I just heard
yeah,
that.
Yeah, so it's not that the screwdriver isn't charged, it's that these are in there.
Whatever lets you sleep at night.
Well, it just broke the screw off,
yeah,
so...
It is a shitty screw.
That could be it. And there's still another... Here.
Wow, we know it's rock solid now. That one's not coming out. Nope.
Okay. Well, let's see what we've done to the delicate electronic components.
Yay!
We're gonna need that.
We're gonna need that.
Yeah.
Oh. Same one? There it is.
Okay. And we're gonna want to get into this compartment.
Oh, that's cool.
What? Oh, it's all captive. Is it loose?
No.
All right, start here.
Oh. Those three are all, yeah.
Yep, okay. Those three are all connected together, and I'm pretty sure that's the power supply / CPU.
All yours.
Thank you.
Hmm. So it doesn't actually screw into the case in any way.
Work out the other ones?
Uses those wedges to lock it in.
Yeah. Oh no, it screws into the case. These.
No, it doesn't screw into the case.
This doesn't screw nope. into. This just pulls up. Oh, it locks into. Oh my god.
Have a look. So I got channels down in the bottom. Here.
Yeah, they in the channels, and these when they tighten, pull the wedges.
Yeah, so I've got a wedge up the wedge up there, and a wedge way down the bottom, and tightening or loosening that screw.
Yeah, I've never seen that.
Oh, hang on. It's written on the side.
It's a Birchner wedge lock 42-1006-4.000598. The Birchner wedge lock, which is also that's the same system they use in the triple tree of a bike, up in the head of a bicycle. Yeah. It's the same. Yep. Yeah,
that's exactly right.
That is so sexy.
Except that's from both ends.
Yeah. Now I got to dig out a screwdriver.
Oh.
What?
Custom?
Huh?
That's been customized.
They're called bodge wires.
Yeah.
It's really cool what you can build when you don't care what it costs.
Yeah.
Hold the back of that. If you would, please.
Oh.
You got it?
Good.
Okay. One of us has got to quit moving. Oh, the screwdriver doesn't fit. Hang on.
Good.
Yeah? Lovely. All right, so we've got some really sexy componentry here. Whoa. I thought these were just like caps, like filter caps. They're not. Mm-hmm. These have a lot of connections out the back. So that could be all kinds of, well, it screws down. What happens if I take the screw out? Probably
nothing.
In the
room dies.
This is the plutonium power pellet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We all die. There's really not much to that.
Well, this weird thing is labeled 53711-668-718-0-001-9747, and then MFR, manufacturer, 35351. Mm-hmm. And they're all the same.
No, that's a 4.5 and a 4.6, and yours is a 4.6.
Oh, 9747, 9745, 9746. Okay. Now we've got some lytic caps over here. Mm-hmm. Jantx, J-A-N-T-X, 2N7225. So I'm guessing that's probably a transistor. C9708BEO with a little delta triangle on the bottom there. What are these and why is this red and why is this? But this is such alien stuff. Like, I've never seen circuit boards look like this. And that, look at that. Something tells me these are not components you just buy from Mauser.
Certainly has that look about it.
The prettiest blue passives you've ever seen. I think they're resistors.
I like the time they took to color code their wires on the trend.
It's all just so beautiful. That's really amazing. Hmm. What else do we have in that box? Is there?
That was it. Oh, there's some.
What about up in the front?
There's some connections down the bottom.
Oh, it's really just connections.
That's about it.
And some things for lights. I want
those plugs.
I want to get this open because I want those.
Okay. What are those?
I think they're indicator lights. They're really interesting, really unusual.
There's your applied analytics maker plate.
This is an applied analytics part number 174596-01. But I want...
Smith's Industries?
I want those. Yeah, it's made in Grand Rapids. Made right here in Grand Rapids. We gotta figure out how to get into here. And the way into there is by getting those out.
Okay.
I don't actually know.
I think that holds this whole thing together. Yeah.
Okay.
That's how we get into there.
Okay.
All right. You start working your way in through the top, and that I'm coming in through the back because I got a lot of screws back here.
So do I.
That are filled with paint.
Good.
But I'll get them.
Make it work for them.
I'm patient.
Good.
Also, I have science.
Just want to let you know.
Die on me now.
Just want to let you know.
What?
I've done 5 screws in the time it's taken you to do one.
Yeah?
Just wanting it out there.
But you're highly motivated.
No. You're just old and slow. Ooh. Wall socket.
That totally helped.
It's all right. If it helps you at all, I'll give you a hand once I'm done.
Now you got a lot more to do.
No. You're really working that, aren't you?
It's a gift.
Mm-hmm. It's that 1/16th of a turn every time. That's really giving you the speed advantage. Just gonna let that go. You want a hand?
No, I'm cool.
Okay.
You still got more screws to get out.
How many you got there?
I got 2.
There's only 4 screws.
Huh?
That whole time, there's 4 screws.
These screws are very motivated
to
remain where they are.
Are they?
These are serious screws.
Aww. That's cute.
You suck. So you keep making fun of me, and I got a really cool system.
Yeah?
Yeah, you know the YouTube videos of the screaming goat?
Yeah.
They're just going to replace your head with the screaming goat.
Okay.
Okay. For the whole video, I'm going to turn and be like, so, what do you think of that, Harvey? And turn and go, meh! And it's just going to be the whole video.
I'm okay with that.
It'd probably get more hits than this video.
Yeah. You know what sucks? There's that one we couldn't get out.
Yeah. We're gonna have to get it out.
Yeah. Have you got a drill here?
Drill?
Yeah. No. Oh.
Spared no expense.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
We did the tools for the autopsy set like
all
forever
set up
ago.
And charged and ready to go.
It probably was. That thing's got a few years on it.
Oh.
Don't worry. When it isn't getting left unplugged and going dead over months, it's left
plugged
in charging for months on end. Yeah.
Yeah.
Which is, they love that.
They
it's
love
totally
it.
Great.
It's the best thing to do.
I wonder. That's totally a good idea.
That is not a good idea.
It's totally a good idea.
How gentle am I being with this board?
I don't care at all about the board.
Excellent.
Board never looked. What in the hell are you doing?
Did I break that?
I think, perhaps, maybe.
Right. We're gonna have to come at it from the bottom.
So flip it over.
Oh.
What?
Still cables connected.
Okay. So, like most little panel mount things like this, mm-hmm. from switches to headphone jacks to car stereo knobs,
yep.
these have that really thin little hex nut
yep.
on the front. I've just been quietly taking them all off.
Mm-hmm.
And I can feel a lot of resistance on this last one, so it's going to fall. Yeah, and that whole module
just pops right out.
Complete with all the nifty things. Now, that's my module. So now I just got to get in the back here and figure this out.
Large set of channel locks.
I wonder if I even need to take that off, because that's a pin header for the whole thing. I could probably just mount this right on a thing, feed it off an Arduino, and be set. Channel locks? Do you need bigger?
Nope.
Okay. I'm going to put this back together, because this is the kind of thing that could make an appearance in my car if I'm smart and keep all the mounting nuts.
Do you want to be really useful right now?
What?
Just hold that. Box. That's cute.
I'd like to point out it was my grip that held, not yours.
Uh-huh.
Petunia. That's totally comfortable.
Yep.
Ah! Hang on.
What?
Oh, it's the whole thing over. Okay. There, here, let me
just
help you out with that.
Cool.
Because you're reefing on this with a pair of pliers. I'm like, that ain't right. Hang on. I'd like to point out that I just did with three fingers when you could do a big pair of channel locks.
Mm-hmm,
okay.
Mm-hmm.
Just saying. I can help you out. You need me to hold that for you again?
Nope. Nope.
Okay. You sure you don't want me coming here and just do that with
my
fingertips?
I'll learn that lesson.
Okay.
You make it harder than it needs to be.
I make it hard.
I'll just do it myself.
What?
What? I'm learning. I'm learning.
So what you got there?
It is a dingus.
It's a dingus?
It's a wing.
Where'd the other dingus? Oh, okay.
It's a wing wong for grinding smoke.
Oh, okay. There's no easy way to take this plug off of that, is there? It's all like soldered in and...
There's a way to do it, but I don't need to.
Okay.
The next guy who wants it needs to.
You know what we should do?
We should connect the plugs.
Put the plugs on there and just leave it sitting.
It's probably a good idea.
I'd cut this back about here, trim it off. That's a sexy plug.
That's all it... That's what does it for you?
What?
Just a really cool plug?
I like a good, sexy plug.
Okay.
It really doesn't take a lot for me.
No, you're easy.
I'm simple. There's advantages to that. I'm happy all the time. That's really quite something. So I got to figure out if these are indicator lights and figure out things about them and figure out what voltage they want at all, because I got a button. I got a light,
mm-hmm.
and these, if you look inside, have like a little radiation symbol to them. I think that this is an electrically actuated mechanical thing, like a kind of solenoid. I think this is kind of like a flip dot thing, where you give it a charge and it changes state and it indicates something happened.
Well, the button is your self-test button.
Because these don't move. These aren't like fuses or breakers or anything like that. So this is a self-test button, and I think when you press this, these all light up or something. On the back, I got a whole bunch of standoffs that poke through, and they've all got numbers and stuff on them, and then they all feed out to this, which is a standard pin socket, so I can feed this off a header, and yeah, so this might have an Arduino in its future.
Cool.
Yeah, that could be cool.
Wrong size. That was connected to something. Oh. Someone has destroyed the back of this screwdriver. It hurts.
Tell you, there's a reason they moved all you guys down to a penal colony in the middle of nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
You wouldn't take care of good tools. That's what did it. That's how you get sent to a penal colony.
That's the only reason.
Disrespecting good tools.
Ah.
Where's this one go?
I'm working on it.
Oh, it's that piece?
Yeah.
Okay. Because I'm like, it doesn't fit there, and it doesn't
nope.
fit there.
So nope.
I'm confused.
That's okay.
You happy with that?
I am now. Sir.
Oh, yeah.
Solid connection.
Yeah, that's if your life has to depend on it because you're going to space, that's the connection you want. That is so cool. Well, that was fun.
Excellent.
That was neat. So that is a teardown of a Smith Industries inertial gyro nav setup dingus thing
widget.
Of awesomeness. It's a widget.
It's a wing wall.
Yeah, it's a smoke grinder.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So you guys have fun. I'm Chris.
I'm Javi.
And we'll be back next time. See you.
Bye.
This video was made possible by a grant from the Future Girl Foundation.
This video was made possible by thousands of private donations from members and viewers like you. Please visit thegeekgroup.org for more information on how you can donate and become a part of our dreams of Avalon.